My name's Mark Lubetsky. I'm the guitar tech for Twiggy Ramirez. Have been for a few years. Love it. Great job. What we have here is we have our what we call our guitar rig, and that consists of all our effects pedals and our amplifiers. Okay. And the only thing you're not seeing here is our pedal board and our cabinets, which are out on the stage.
I'm learning something right now.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
It's been great. We all are. It's an educational experience.
So what we have here, I'll just go through the racks here. These are just wireless units. He can run around and play anywhere, and these wireless units split into a switcher, and that goes into these here. And what these are loop controllers for all these different effects that we have. These are in the rack so he does not have to, you know, press them down on and off, and he's tap dancing all night, and he has all kinds of, you know, problems out there with cables coming unplugged. They're all in here. They don't move. The settings don't change. They're always on. Everything's automated, and it's all automated via MIDI. And he has a MIDI controller, and he pushes a button. He turns on three or four at a time, one at a time. He can turn them off. He can change all the amplifier channels with the push of a button. And it's really probably the easiest way to do it, as opposed to you going, you know, turn this and that. It's just one button does everything.
Can we check out the pedals again?
Yeah, of course, yeah. What we got here is we have a couple delays, a flanger, an acoustic guitar simulator right here. This back here is a overdrive pedal. It's a box of rock. Both ZVX pedals. This is a super hard-on right here is what they call that one.
Mark always has super hard-ons.
Yes, always. We always have one with us. Framptone Peach Fuzz, which is one of the coolest fuzzes we've found, actually.
Peter Frampton.
Ultimate Octave, which is an octave pedal. It gives you a higher pitch sound. Chorus pedal, which is, this is a small clone, a classic style chorus from Electro Harmonix. Reverb, overdrive right here. And these of course, you'll see in every drawer. These are just my power supplies. They're not in any type of effect. These in here, this is one of the coolest delays you'll ever find, a super delay. Another reverb pedal. Of course, we have a big muff, every good rig does, and a Phase 90, of course. Those are classics.
Why not?
Yep. And down here, a couple off-the-wall pedals. This is a lo-fi junkie. Kind of gives you that old record, worn-out record sound. It's really cool. Really cool for us. And this right here is an Eventide space pedal. And this pedal is reverbs and echoes and all kinds of cool modulation centering around the reverb. Something that Eventide came out with a couple years ago that we really love. Has a lot of cool sounds that you can't really find anywhere else.
Great box, too.
Yeah. Then over here we have our amplifiers. We love our diesel amps. Their sound is like no other. The voicing is beautiful. They're so characteristic of like a heavier sound, but we can get any sound we want out of them, from clean to crunch to heavy to super lead. We use this one as our main amp, a VH4, and this one down here is a diesel Herbert. It's actually a lot louder than this amp, the VH4, and it gives it the same tonal qualities, a little bit tighter, heavier, kind of squeezed together sound. They both sound great. We just prefer this. If we need to, we'll use this one, and we know that we'll have a good sound no matter what. And of course, we ran out the bottom with a Mesa Boogie, the Old Faithful.
Of course.
Yeah. This is just running on a clean, just like many players do, that you'll never see. You'll never see those Mesas running clean. Everyone's got one, usually.
Because we run a heavy sound and a clean sound at the same time and kind of blend them together for the sound, man. Just for, I don't know.
The amp blend gives you so much more of a choice in what you sound like. You know, he can say, I need more low end. And I'm like, well, what kind of low end do you want to hear? And he'll be like, well, it's just not woofy enough. And I know that's this amp, as opposed to like this amp that would be a little bit more thin sounding because it's not as clean. It's more distorted. So it all depends what he asks for. Usually I can determine which amp we need to adjust. And it's not usually volume. It's more tone than that.
That's why he gets the big bucks.
Yeah, right.